So are diet sodas really as bad as people make them out to be? It takes just a few searches online, and the negativity and fear-mongering around diet drinks is really clear to see. But what is the truth about diet sodas? Is there justification for all the fear? Or have people's attitudes been formed by sensationalist media pieces and content designed purely to drive high views? So as someone who consumes diet drinks, I've always been of the everything in moderation mindset. I think they taste good. I think they're great at helping you deal with sugar cravings and helping you stick towards a calorie-controlled diet. But with all the negative press out there, it made me wonder, am I risking my health by drinking them? So in this video, I've looked at some of the most common objections to drinking diet sodas and looked to see if there's any science to actually back any of these things up. Now, every brand of diet soda will have slightly different ingredients. So for simplicity, I've focused on Diet Coke and Coke Zero, as this is the most popular brand. So something I hear a lot is that diet drinks are just full of chemicals. And in fact, these chemicals are so toxic that you're probably better off just drinking the full sugar equivalent. Now, this is a classic appeal to nature fallacy. And just because something is natural doesn't mean that it's automatically healthy. And in the same way, just because something is synthetic doesn't mean that it's automatically unhealthy. Now, it's worth mentioning that everything is a chemical. In fact, Lane Norton recently posted about this on his Facebook page, and he posted the chemical ingredients for an organic banana. Now, when you read through that list, it all sounds pretty scary, especially if you don't know what a lot of these chemicals are. But of course, you would never normally be worried about eating an organic banana. Now, there are 9 ingredients within a Coke Zero, the most controversial of which is probably going to be aspartame. Now, I'm going to go into more detail specifically about aspartame in just a moment, but it's one of the most thoroughly tested and studied food additives the FDA has ever approved. So despite diet drinks having 0 calories, there are still plenty of claims that they still cause weight gain and diabetes. However, from all the studies I've seen, they definitely show a correlation but not a causation. In the same way that the annual number of people that drowned falling into a pool correlates very strongly with the number of films Nicolas Cage was in, again, correlation does not equal causation. So from the diabetes studies, it's seen that most of the participants were already overweight and predisposed to having type 2 diabetes. In other studies, it seems like there were some behavioral reasons why the participants kept gaining weight while drinking diet sodas. The most likely theory is that the participants were eating additional food because of the calories they had saved by not drinking the full sugar versions of the sodas. So as mentioned earlier, aspartame has been highly criticized and highly controversial ever since it was first approved by the FDA in the early 1980s. It's now one of the most widely used and well-studied sweeteners in the world. There have been lots of studies where participants have ingested huge amounts of aspartame over long periods of time, and there have never been any observable side effects or results. As such, there are no scientific links to brain tumors or cancer. Observational studies are often sensationalized by the media, which then leads to lots of anxiety amongst consumers. Now, from these studies, there is an ADI value for aspartame, which is the acceptable daily intake. This is the maximum amount of a chemical that can be ingested daily over a lifetime with no appreciable health risk. Now, the very conservative ADI value for aspartame is 50 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. Now, there's 184 milligrams of aspartame in a can of Coke Zero. So an 80 kilogram person could have up to 22 cans of diet soda per day over a lifetime with no appreciable health risk, which is insane. Now, when we consume aspartame, it's broken down into our body into 3 different compounds. It's 50% phenylalanine, 40% aspartic acid, and 10% methanol. Now, methanol raises the most eyebrows, as this is actually converted into formaldehyde within the body. Now, this sounds absolutely horrendous, but formaldehyde is actually used for certain processes within the body, including making certain amino acids, and it doesn't actually build up or store within the body. Any excess of formaldehyde is actually converted into formic acid, which is excreted from the body when you pee. Now, it's also worth noting that the amount of methanol produced by aspartame is very, very small. And in fact, there's higher amounts of methanol found naturally within fruits and vegetables. So as such, an equivalent amount of fruit juice can have 5 times the amount of methanol than a diet soda. So BPA, otherwise known as bisphenol A, is an industrial chemical used to produce certain plastics and resins. It's shown to have quite a nasty effect on the human body, and it's already been restricted across the EU, Canada, China, and Malaysia. So BPA can actually seep into beverages and food if it's within the containers. This is why you've probably heard of BPA-free plastics when you're talking about drinks bottles, food containers, and baby bottles. So even though diet sodas are most commonly contained within an aluminium container, they actually have a very, very thin plastic lining. Now, this is very well designed and very difficult to see. However, someone dissolved the aluminium can using sodium hydroxide, very Breaking Bad style, and revealed the inner plastic lining. This lining is designed to stop the metal being corroded by the drink inside. Now, looking online, that lining does actually seem to contain BPA, but it is trace amounts. The FDA has said that BPA levels are safe at around 50 micrograms per kilogram of body weight. So again, for an 80 kilogram person, you're talking 4,000 micrograms per day. Within each can of diet soda, there's between 1.7 and 3.5 micrograms of BPA. So again, we're really talking very small amounts. So our blood sugar levels increase when we eat carbohydrates. When they're digested, they're broken down into sugar and absorbed into our bloodstream. And this increase in blood sugar levels triggers the release of insulin. So insulin is a hormone that transports sugars from our bloodstream into our cells for energy or to be stored as fat. So because aspartame doesn't contain any sugar, it shouldn't cause an insulin response. Now, despite a lot of claims that it does, in 1998, the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition performed a study on 48 healthy people where they were given large dosages of aspartame for 20 days, an equivalent to 20 cans of diet soda. The researchers found that there was no effect on their insulin levels. So the impact of gut bacteria on overall health is still being explored. But the research suggests that your balance of gut bacteria could be an indicator as to your susceptibility to different health conditions and may even be the key to preventing or even treating certain diseases. So one study has shown a change in the balance of gut bacteria in mice when they were fed artificial sweeteners, and this included a reduction in some of the good bacteria. This definitely needs further investigation and human studies to determine the effects on people. The issue is that everyone's balance of gut bacteria is very different and unique, and so complex that it's very difficult to measure or even say for certain which bacteria are the most beneficial. There are trillions of gut bacteria made up of thousands of different species and 5,000 bacterial strains. So as it stands, nothing can be said for certain about the effects of artificial sweeteners on the gut microbiome, but I'm definitely interested in finding out more from further studies. So when most people think about tooth decay and cavities, they typically think about sugary foods and sugary drinks being the issue. However, despite the fact diet sodas have no sugar in them whatsoever, they've been found to create a similar amount of dental erosion as their sugary counterparts. Now, the reason for this is because the ingredients in the diet sodas are actually quite acidic and can actually dissolve the protective enamel on your teeth. Now, this can be minimized by drinking through a straw or having the drinks with a meal. So another popular belief is that diet drinks could actually impact your bone density. And there is an element of truth to this. Now, diet drinks contain phosphoric acid. And while phosphorus is an important bone mineral in itself, a disproportionate amount of phosphorus compared to your intake of calcium could lead to bone loss. Now, it's worth pointing out, however, that the amount of phosphorus in diet drinks is very, very small compared to things like chicken or cheese. Another possible issue is that the caffeine in diet drinks can actually prevent calcium from being absorbed. However, the negative effects of calcium absorption by caffeine can be fully offset by as little as 1 to 2 tablespoons of milk. So to try and form some kind of meaningful conclusion to this, my thoughts are that there's a lot of media sensationalism around diet sodas. Ultimately, it's a matter of choice, but from what I've found out, I'm more than happy to drink them in moderation as part of a balanced, healthy diet. Now, of course, if you're worried about it or you're experiencing any kind of negative side effect from drinking diet sodas or you have some kind of underlying health condition, then obviously stop drinking them. My only real concerns were about the tooth enamel, which I found pretty eye-opening, and I'll definitely be keeping an eye out for further studies on the gut microbiome. However, I think there are a lot of health benefits to losing weight, and if drinking diet sodas helps you achieve that, I think that's a good thing. So if you've watched this video to the end, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you found it useful. And comment below. Let me know what you think about drinking diet sodas.